Welcome, Vladimir, from Moscow, and he's going to tell us something about XXE and blind XXE injections. So give him a warm welcome and enjoy the talk.
So, let's go. I'm Vladimir Rantsov from Moscow, from Russia, from Onsec company. So, I will speak about blind XXE injections, also named as XML external entity. First, some autobiography. That's my biography, of course. I'm working in web application security area since 2004 year and founder of XSpeed of Onsec company since 2009 year. And nowadays I also develop of self-learning systems for the detection of attacks of application and the heuristic analysis. And that's all. Now about XXE. What we know about XML external entity attacks. At this slide, you can see basics of XML external entity attacks consist of possibility to read local files and included contents into XML documents. The main threat of that attacks, it is of course read local files, but that attacks can be also used to make denied of service by reading and D0 or other loop devices, or also by reading large files, for example, page file sys and Windows hosts. At this slide also, you can see a simple example of external entity definition in the terms of XML. And after define entity, you can also include that content of that entity into your XML structure by using a ampersand character. At that example, we include a content of etc passed file into a tag of the XML. It is very, very basic. So, some XXE application, some well-known XXE applications. First of all, it is of course local files reading. An example, etc password is shown in this slide. Second, it is internal network resources attacks provide attacker to read content from internal networks, because in modern web application we have some service in internal network, and if you have one vulnerability on backend, you can also send a request from that backend from another. An example, you can read internal wiki resources. You can also use that vulnerability to port scan, because there is no restriction in XML parsers which make that request by ports. If you put that URL in your browser, you have an error, because all modern browsers, client browsers, protect users and blocked match number of ports. An example, 22 port. But XML parser didn't do that. And that URL was valid in terms of XML parser's rules. So, also XXEA attacks could provide us to read Microsoft internal networks resources. An example, Active Directory on something else and shared hosts which connect to vulnerable host. And also, modern XXE attacks can also used various wrappers. An example, LDAP and something else wrappers in Perl and libxml in Perl, and expect and sh2 and some other wrappers in PHP. It's very important, but it isn't new. It isn't new. So, something about classic XXE vulnerability and the classic XXE vulnerability restriction. First of all content receiving from XXE vulnerability based on web application error message. It is a main limit of all XXE vulnerability and attacks based on that vulnerability. To read any file content using XXE strongly required an error message from a business logic of application returned to you, to your host, to your HTTP response. And there is no way to read file content without that. It is very a big limit for that vulnerability. So that is the slide. You can also see an example messages from real applications. An example, a known language which data is the data from XML, and the login data are not valid, or password for user data doesn't match to password, and data, it is a content of file. So also you can read files with a special character which make HTML markup malformed. It is a low bytes character, an example null byte and something else. It is also a quote character and also symbols of greater and smaller. That characters make XML markup malformed, and you can't read content of that files. So it is example of real world XXE vulnerability find in more than 10,000 of service in the Yandex company at last year. This vulnerability was found in terms of contents month of Yandex bug hunting, and you can see at this slide exploit output of that vulnerability, and SOAP response message consists of header and interesting data. Interesting data marked as green color, and that is an ETC password content which I can read from many numbers of Yandex service at last year. So this is all about classical XXE, and what's wrong in that vulnerability. First, web application might not display error messages. In many numbers on web application where XML external entity vulnerability exists, in our security audits we can't read files because there are no error messages displayed to us. It is very, very strong limit. So you may also want to get XML file context, because XML files generally use it to configure a web application service and something else. And in real penetration testing and real security audits, it's strongly needed to read configuration files from a host machine using any numbers of vulnerabilities, an example using based on XXE. Interesting XML files which can read by attackers, it is web XML files, it is Tomcat users files using by Tomcat service to make a basic authorization. Also it is JT XML and HTTP conf of a patch web server, but HTTP conf, it is not not well formatted XML, because it is config file have a many character of a cell that make all XML malformed. So in terms of PHP, there are great way to read anything you want, because PHP provide us to use the wrappers, and the simple way to read anything context, in example XML content on or binary content, it is using wrappers. In PHP interpreter, the easy way to convert anything file context into base 64 valid string. It is string consists of only ASCII characters, and this string didn't broke XML format. So, and also, even you use a PHP wrappers to take an attack on web application, you also need to display an errors too. It's a very very big restriction to using this vulnerability in real life, as I said. So, what's blind? The main idea of using blind based on possibility to read a validation status. It's maybe a DTD validation or XSD validation, but of course XSD validation is rare. So we can use brute force techniques, regular expression search, a binary search, and error message information, called also error-based attacks, to read external XML structure and, that more important, XML data. It is data in XML tags and the data from XML attributes. So, it is a simple formula of DTD-based attack. XML input consists of internal DTD in that XML input and the XML internal, some XML internal tags, and also you can attach external XML into your XML using XML external entity vulnerability. And the external XML, in example web XML, in example JTXML, in example Tomcat, users XML marked as red. You can see also at this slide validation function equation where V is validation function. Validation function is additive in the terms of validation status of XML consists of two XML is equal to validation status is of valid all this XML both. You can also read some definition of that variable below. I think it is a very simple formula, and we can look at the XML external entity attack based on DTD schema. First of all, input document by attacker may consist a entity definition with a reference to external XML file, in example web XML, two line from a screen, and also external document may a reference of content of that variable in a root tag, as shown at that part of slide. The next, PHP parser may find local files called WebXML with the content secret in the tag and the tag any with the valid data, and include that content in your XML. And your XML have a structure like that. In the root tag now, we have a secret tag and the any tag and the data value of the tag. Then XML parser, if they configured in a validation process, make a validation operation, and of course that XML is not valid. You get a validation error. If you couldn't read a validation error in the HTTP output, you also could get a validation status. So, attacker in that case modify input XML and include to that definition of web XML and define element root and element secret and element any. Then XML validation status is valid. The main thing of that attacks is brute DTD definitions until validation status of whole document be valid. So, it is example to read attribute value from XML document based on errors from different XML parsers. In libxml, if you define that that DTD using at least with attribute k and the value of a or b and the real value of k attribute id is secret, you get an error like that. in a libxml, you get error, that value is secret, and the secret of data of that attribute, which you may read for attribute ID of mountains is not among of the enumerating set. That's really very informative for hackers. And if case, if you use a Xerxes parser, you can read a error that attribute K with value secret must have a value from the list is A and B. In both in that cases, attacker which can read a error message can read a attribute value, and that attribute value and that XML, as we show before, can be from external XML which can read. So, example two, based on brute force XML root tag. First of all, attacker also create an input XML with a reference to a local XML file. Then attacker include content of that file in the tag, in example root tag, and then define a definition of DTD schema consists of element with any child, in example foobar child. In real document in variable R we have not a foobar child but something else, and you can brute force foobar until error message will not removed, and because if error message said you that your child tag is not equal to foobar, you could not read that tag, and if you have no error message, that foobar is equal of content of your XML tag. It is example works fine on libxml, but with a great restriction, which I told later. So, three example to read external XML in Java uses Xerxes parsers with realization of SAX or DOM or something else. There is no difference between realization of Xerxes parser. First, attacker create a doc type element and include into the entity local files WebXML. Then validation process generate an error message consists the name of first element which malformed. In that example you have an error element type must be declared, but where is the bar tag at that cases? The bar tag at the first tag in the WebXML, and then attacker which may read error messages can tag by tag receive all XML structure of WebXML file. It is an example relevant to Java and Xerxes. So, problems of DTD based attacks. First of all, I must say that example 3 didn't work in libxml, because libxml have a main bug consists of only first tag from external document structure will be put in validation process. I don't understand why, but it is work. And we can't read any tags and any attributes expect of first in terms of libxml in a PHP. But it is a not great restriction, because as I said before, in PHP you can use a simple way using wroppers and read anything as you want, in example XML, binary data and something else. And even in some cases And some really audits, we also read wall block devices by that vulnerability. It's very strange, but it's possible. We read block devices because while we read a block device file from a Unix system, we have no file system restrictions, and we have no any restrictions to user and privileges because you have only block bytes. It's very usable. So. Second problem, the DTD can be used to determine tag values, only attribute values and only XML structure. It is a great problem because in many XML files, in example WebXML, maybe exist some private data required to attacker from XML tags. Also, a main problem of DTD validation attacks is a brute force required. Because if not, no errors displayed in the output, you must only use brute force. It's very long. It's very difficult to create a automatization of that, and attack take a long time. It's very bad. It's also malformed XML such as HTTP conf can be readed because malformed XML could not be validated in any cases without a require of your DTD schema. So after DTD, I want to talk about XSD-based attacks described of that formula. First of all, XML input consists of DTD input and XSD, and that is a great difference between DTD attacks and XSD attacks, and the XML internal and the XML external, where XML external, it is external XML which you want to read, an example WebXML or something else. Validation equation of that case will shown at the second line. Also, validation function of DTD and the XSD validation is additive 2. And the validation status of wall document consists of validation status of first part and the validation status of external part based on a validation process on external external XML. So, definition of that equation can be found it at that below the slide. Find it is below the slide. Attack used that vulnerability displayed at this slide. Also, first of all, attacker may describe the X entity in input XML and create a reference to a local XML file. In that case, it's WebXML. Then attacker provide a XSD schema in a root tag. In that case, it's XML schema hosted on attacker host called myhost and have a name int XSD. Then attacker put a reference from external XML file into a tag value. At that example, it is a ext entity. Then XML parser put a XML content from a external file to a input XML, and XML file became that structure. Also, input XML file now have a secret tag with any child with a data value. Then XML parser try to validate this document using DTD and using XSD schema. First of all, of course, the document isn't valid. And then attacker may modify XSD to make that document valid. After that, attacker can obtain some information from external document because because XSD schema described by attacker. So, example 4, it is a way to read tag values using XSD validation and Java, and that Java code Java code provides this vulnerability. First of all, to make a XSD validation parser active in Java code, you may use a set property call. Then, of course, you need to get a reference from an external document and include internal schema into input XML. In the terms of Java, in that case, at that document and that code, you get an error message like that. First of all, error message said the value secret is not valid to integer value, because that definition hope that all values of tag password have an integer type. And while value password is not integer, parser generates that error. And the second error from validation process said that the value secret of element password is not valid wall. It is a parser walk. So how many cases and how many ways we use that vulnerability to obtain data? First of all, of course, it is error-based attacks, because if you have a if you get a error message from server, you can read this error message and find out real data of external XML in a error message. But in many cases, we have no way to read a display error messages. It is not rare cases. It, I must say that it is a really general case in real web applications from our audits when we could not read XML and other errors from web application. Only HTTP status, like 500s or not, or 200s, an example. In that cases, we can use blind techniques based on a binary search or regular expression search or something else. That techniques also known as double blind in terms of SQL injections. And attacks architecture described at that slide. First of all, attacker may create XSD definition make true when a first character of a value which can which they would read between A and N. It is a half of English alphabets. And step by step, attacker can obtain information in about the first character of a tag value, followed by that algo. An example, if a validation status of check A between A and N is not valid, attacker may use a second equation and the check is first character of password between M and Z. If this equation is valid, attacker may create a distance between letters narrow and step by step read a first byte of a tag value. It is not simple way, but it is really useful in real applications, real security audits, where know any way and know any vulnerabilities instead of XXE vulnerabilities, find it. It is not a fast way, but we can get that way more faster using some techniques called also phonetic chains, because all languages and all words in that have some phonetics correlations and provide a phonetics analysis. We can use a paper described using phonetics chain in terms of SQL injections, published by me and my colleague from Positive Technologies in 9 years. And that link. It is a screenshot from that article. We can use probability with which one letter follows another one, and make our binary search faster. It's get 20% average speed than classical binary search described that. So, five example describe binary search to take value in XSD using techniques which I described at that slide. That XSD content described a new type called PVD and consists of one pattern value with regular expression which make valid while first character of password became value between A and M, and then get a validation status false in other cases. Then attacker may read byte by byte all password, and if first character of password take of value A between M, then validation status will true and else false. Can also used phonetic chains to make this process more faster. Well, and what about attacks without any validation statuses? In many cases, in many web applications, there are XML external entity attacks, but they are not way to read validation status. It is not good for attacker and not good for us as auditors, because we can't read real file contents. But if you do the same thing as SQL injection time-based attacks, you can hope that techniques also work to XML external entity attacks. But it isn't true in Vol. First of all, XSD parsers validate all tags, and even if some of them already not valid, XML parsers didn't finish validation process. XSD parser collect all errors and take output of that. It is very bad for attackers, because attacker in that case could not read information from XML. It is the main difference, if I can say about that XML parsers and interpreter. Interpreter read file read by line by line. What we can do in that case? I think it is a question for you. Any suggestions? I think it will be a homework. All right. Example fix described attacks in that case. While an attacker could not create a validation status. It is some trick based on parser process and based on XSD definition. That trick can also used in some guys to create time-based attacks in time-based attacks in terms of SQL injection, where web application firewall blocked many signatures, in example benchmark and example MD5 and something else, very popular functions to make time-based attacks. That example consists of possibility of parser to choose a group to a value. And if value of secret, which you can read, approach to group condition group consists of something like that, parsing process not take a while. Yeah, but if value of secret tag is not matched to condition group, parser try to match value to a high load group, and your task is create a high load group very hard to parse. In example, you create a large regular expression and set to parser parse that regular expression. As you know, all regular expression in all programming languages and all interpreters take a while. It's really hard operation, and it's a simple to create a big regular expression to make process validation hard. Then you can get a time-based XXE attack. If value of text secret match to condition group, validation time is small. And in other cases, validation time take a while. It is very simple to distribute or that conditions when you make attacks on asynchronous synchronous requests, and in asynchronous case it is impossible because you have no receive a time of request process. So problems of XSD based attacks. First of all, that internal XSD validation are not common in the wild. It's very rare. Only 4% of all web applications which we analyzed since 9 years and which also contain a XXE vulnerability was vulnerability also to XSD attacks. It's a very low percent. So, could not used to read malformed XML. There are no way, and I really didn't know any way exclude PHP wrappers to read malformed XML such as HTTP conf. It is a real hard file to read using XML. I think that's all. If you have questions, you can ask me.